Hello, in the last lecture we have seen the bobbin built on the ring frame. So today we shall see the drive on the ring frame, how this bobbin construction is being actually done with the use of mechanisms. So before we go any further, let us again look at the passage, or rather revise the passage in a little bit of more detail. The passage of the yarn through the ring frame is like this. There is a delivery from the front roller. The roving bobbin feeds the roving to the drafting system, as we have seen earlier. Then the last roller, that is the front roller, delivers the material after drafting it to the appropriate levels to form the yarn. And it is then this material is guided through the yarn guide, which is shown over here. Then it is going through a particular, there is simply a ring over here, which is called as a balloon control ring. We shall see the function later on. Of each of these parts, and this is called as a yarn balloon, that is one can see over here. And whatever material is delivered is being dragged, or rather rotated around this particular ring by this small element known as a traveler. So this is the ring and the traveler, and it is being wound on this particular cop, which is fixed onto the spindle, and spindle has is being rotated in this manner. So whatever tensions are there in the region, entire region is being divided into three main parts. That is spinning tension, which is between the front roller and the yarn guide. Then there is something known as a balloon tension, which will be there due to the balloon that is being formed here, and it is between the yarn guide and the this particular region where the yarn will enter the traveler. And from there, from the traveler and ring position to the cop, the tension that is generated is called as a winding tension. So this is how the material goes through, and this is slightly a close-up of how the ring and the traveler would look like. The traveler is simply a sort of a small clip which is there on the ring, which will rotate continuously for winding as well as twisting of the yarn. So with this, we shall again revise a little bit onto what we have seen last time, the layering traverse and the switching traverse. These are the names given to the layers as they are being built up. So let us see. Last time we have seen the main traverse, or the main layer and the cross layer, and this time we shall see how they are identified, so that in the coming slides we will be able to understand it better. So to build a cop built bobbin, as described earlier, the following two functions must be performed by the ring frame. The raising and lowering of the ring rail for each double traverse to build the main and the cross windings, that is this particular function, or this particular whatever the ring frame is doing, this particular function, that is layer lowering and raising of this particular ring rail together, it is called, known as the layering traverse, and it is around 15 to 18% larger than the ring diameter. So, and the second function that this particular ring rail has to perform is that of the raising of the ring rail. So after each completion of this particular double layer that we have just seen, which is called as a layering traverse, after that the ring rail has to raise a little bit for each traverse, each subsequent traverse. And this raising of the ring rail after completion of each layer is known as the switching traverse. So we have identified two different functions for the ring rail, which we shall use these terms later on in our slides. So again, just to revise and see how this particular was running, pay particular attention to the speed of this particular ring rail as it is moving up and down. Is moving upwards slowly as discussed, and rapidly it is coming down for the formation of the cross layer. Okay, so this with this revision, now we are ready to see the that we have already discussed this. So again, just to revise it so that we understand the drive better. The roving built is parallel, is a parallel wound package, as we have seen. The cob build requires a complicated mechanism and winds the yarn under continuously changing tension. So this is how the cob looks like as against the roving bobbin. But the cob build is ideal for unwinding. Why we are doing this? Because it is ideal for unwinding and permits high unwinding speeds at the subsequent process. So with this, now we are ready to understand the mechanism that is used to build this particular cob. So the formation of the main and the cross layers. So first, let us understand how the main and the cross layers are built, which is also called as a layering traverse, which we have just identified in our earlier slide. So ring rail R, that is this particular ring rail R, which is shown. This is a cross section of the ring frame from the side. So ring rail R hangs because of its own weight. So since this has got weight, it will be hanging and it will try to, this ring rail which is there, one can imagine this is going into the slide. That means this is a cross section when looked at the ring frame from the side. So this is a side cross section, and this particular ring rail being heavy, it will try to move downwards because of its weight, and it will try to pull itself downwards. So this action will try to rotate disc B. So now one can see there is a connection over here. There is simply a connection that is made to this disc B at one particular point. This is not a pulley or anything. Please do not mistake this for pulleys. They are simply discs on this particular shaft, and they are connected via these, one can say these are belts or chains by which they are connected to this disc at a certain point. So when this ring rail, because of its weight, is trying to pull this entire system downwards, this action tries to rotate the disc B mounted on the shaft W and also the disc A on the other side of the shaft. So when this is trying to be pull it downwards, so all these three discs will try to rotate in the clockwise direction. If one is looking at it from the right hand side, it will try to rotate this particular A in the clockwise direction. Disc A helps in pressing the lever H against the heart-shaped cam at O. So when this particular disc is there, it is connected via this particular, one can say drum, which is a T marked over here, and there is a cam over here, one can see, and this is in connection with this particular lever H over here. And because this is always trying to pull it down, and therefore because of this rotation over here, this lever is always made to have a connection with this particular cam over here, and will always be touching this, this follower O will be touching this particular cam E, which is shown here, which is heart shaped. The lever H is raised and lowered as per the shape of the cam. Now this cam has got its speed. Continuous speed it gets from the motor, and this particular cam will rotate at a certain speed, but because of the shape that it is having, the cam will try to push this particular lever as per the design or the shape of this particular cam, and it is shaped in such a manner that it raises the ring rail slowly, because we want the ring rail to move slowly to wind the main layer, and this will enable it will enable the winding of the main layer and vice versa. So at the same time it will be moving rapidly because of the shape when the other part of this cam comes into contact with O over here, and one can get a cross layer by rapid downward movement of the ring rail. So with this we can see the switching traverse. Raising the ring rail after each layering traverse. So once this layering traverse is being built by this particular cam, one must also take care that for the switching traverse, the ring rail has to move upwards. So each time lever H moves down, it presses the ratchet S. So as soon as this H, every time it moves up and down like this, it will push or press against the catch. One of the catches there, which is fixed, and it will result in a small turn of T. Since this ratchet will turn by say certain tooth, and because of the pressing of this particular catch, because this ratchet is then connected is on the same shaft as the drum over here, this drum will also get a small turn and because of this connection with K over here, this chain is being wound on this particular drum. Chain K is therefore wound on a by a small amount on the drum after each layering traverse. The effect is that the disc A, that is this disc A, the shaft W and the disc B turn slightly and raises the ring rail for the switching traverse. So because of this shortening of this particular length over here, every time after each double layer that is being built, main and cross, this particular ring rail will be shifted slightly upwards by a certain amount for the switching layer to take place. The bobbin control rings and the thread guide or the lappets, that the parts that we have just seen, we shall see the function later on of both these elements. But these also get a sort of similar movement just like the ring rail, but with a little bit of a lesser stroke. Because of this B, this ring rail is getting the motion, whereas because of the connection of C over here, there is one more disc as we have mentioned. This will be giving the up and down motion to the lappets as well as the balloon control rings shown over here, F and B. But the stroke that is there, the traverse that traverse length that it travels would be lesser than that of the ring rail. And how it is achieved over here, we shall see in the coming slide. The traverse is smaller since disc C is smaller than disc B. So B, as one can observe, is slightly bigger than that of C over here. The diameter are different, and how this diameter difference helps in giving a different traverse to this ring rail and this particular lappets and balloon control ring, we shall see in the next slide. So for understanding that, let us just revise a little bit as to the relation between linear velocity, say B, and angular velocity, omega. So with this diagram, if any particle is moving along a circle like this, the angle that it makes at the center and this particular arc that it travels along the circumference, we must know what is the relation between this arc that it traverses, which can be termed as the, say, linear velocity, and the angle that it traverses as it moves from A to B, that can be called as angular velocity. So the relation between them is something like this: V is equal to R into omega, or rather omega is equal to V upon R. So where V is a linear velocity and omega is angular velocity. So we shall keep this in mind for understanding the mechanism that we have just seen. So before we go there, let us just look at a small example here. For one complete rotation per unit time of point A and back to A, suppose this particle were to move from A back to A over here and it takes a one complete rotation, the linear distance travelled by it is equal to the circumference of the circle. And one can see easily that the circumference is 2 pi r, and therefore the linear velocity is 2 pi r over here per unit time. Therefore, the angular velocity would be 2 pi r upon r using this particular formula here, and it would be 2 pi, and the unit would be radians. So with this particular background, let us see how it can help us in understanding our mechanism. So since omega is equal to V upon r, and omega is, if in case we say that the omega is constant, then it means that V increases with R. Suppose R were to increase, then in that case V also will increase to keep this particular omega constant. So in the figure, disc A is smaller than disc B and disc C is of a similar size as A. So A and C are almost of the same size, and B here is a slightly larger one. The angular velocity of the shaft W is same. So once this particular, suppose this shaft W were to get any angular velocity, then in that case it would be same for all these discs that are mounted on this particular shaft. The linear velocity of disc B and disc C is almost the same, while that of disc B, linear velocity of disc A and disc C, please read this as A, because these are of the same sizes. The linear velocity of disk A and disk C is almost the same, while that of disk B is more than both these disks. B is more for the same omega. Because R is more, the linear velocity for this particular disk B will be more. Therefore, the balloon control rings and the thread guide or the lappets get a similar movement like the ring rail, but with a lesser stroke. So, since C and A are similar in size, the linear velocity for both these would be same, and it will be lesser when you compare it with that of this particular B, and therefore the connection of B is with the ring rail, which gets a higher stroke length or a traverse length. And due to the C, which is smaller in size, it will give a slightly smaller stroke length to both the lappet as well as the balloon control ring. So after having seen the layering and the switching traverse, let us take a deeper look into the formation of the cop base. We already know that the cop base is going to be barrel shaped because of the way the construction happens from empty bobbin as it is being built up. The conical surface is being built up, and because of this the base becomes slightly rounder in shape. But in addition to this, there is one more mechanism which is being fitted on this particular drive, so that the base becomes more convex or more rounded. And there is a reason for that, so that and that is more amount of yarn can be accommodated in this particular base if it is more rounded rather than flat. So in that case, if we have to see the mechanism over here which builds the rounded bottom over here, so we will have to take a slightly different view of this particular gearing over here, which we shall see shortly. As seen earlier, the convex base is formed due to the specific type of winding. The shape is reinforced by a mechanical device, that is the cam or the cog or the deflector, which is N. And if we look at this particular disc from the right hand side, we can see that on the disc there is a small notch that is there, which is marked as N over here. So the cam N is attached to the disc A, and its projection tends to give the effect similar to an increase in the diameter of the disc A during the initial buildup of the cob base. So during the initial buildup of the cob base, this particular notch has an effect as if this disc A has been increased in diameter. So if there is an increase in diameter, let us see how this particular thing helps us in building the cob base. As the chain gets wound up on the drum T, because of the rotation over here of the disc A in the clockwise direction, it brings the cog out of the path of the chain K, and now the smaller diameter of the disc A oscillates the shaft W. So let us understand the situation here. In the beginning, when the machine starts, when the cob base is being built, this particular notch H helps in sort of giving a similar effect as if this A is of a bigger diameter. And after some time, this notch A would be out of the picture because of the rotation, or rather shortening of this particular chain K, and therefore it is out of the path and it will no longer give the effect of a larger diameter to disc A. So in short, in the beginning, disc A behaves as if it is of a bigger diameter, and later on it will come to its original size. So again, therefore in the beginning, it is as if the diameter of the disc A is large, and once the cob base is built, the diameter is true to the smaller diameter of disc A, which I have just mentioned. So with this in mind, let us see the discussion of this particular formula that we have just seen earlier. Since V is equal to R into omega, and the lever H is raised and lowered with the same linear velocity throughout the build of the bobbin, since R of disc A is large in the beginning, so the radius, the cog N helps in a similar way as if it is the disc A has increased in size. So in that case, the angular velocity omega is lesser. So R is big in this formula, so omega would be lesser. So therefore, the entire raising and lowering of the lever is not transferred to the ring rail. So since r is big in the beginning, so the angular velocity that must be transferred to the particular disc B for raising or lowering the particular ring rail, that entire omega is not transferred, and that is why the linear velocity in the beginning would be lesser for the ring rail. And then as the bobbin base is being built up and that cog N is out of path of the chain K, the smaller disc diameter, that is the original disc A diameter, is restored, and therefore it is now able to transfer the entire angular motion to the shaft W, and hence the ring rail. So after the once the cop base is built, the entire motion is transferred, and the normal raising and lowering of the ring rail is possible. So now, since the ring rail was slightly slower in the beginning, so therefore another point that is to be observed here is that the length delivered by the front roller being constant throughout the cop build, and the traverse of the ring rail being lesser in the beginning due to this additional mechanism here, this leads to more yarn being built, being wound in the small traverse length of the cop, resulting in a more rounded shape of the cop base. So in our earlier lecture, we have seen already the cop base is slightly rounded because of the way the construction of the cop is made. And in addition to this, because of this addition of this cog in this mechanism, we can have a still slightly more rounded shape because of this working, as we have just seen. So this kind of a construction of the cop base would allow for more accommodation accommodation of more yarn length at the base, and therefore it leads to the increase in the capacity of the cog. So therefore it is advantageous for us to have this particular cog in the picture, so that already the rounded base would become still more rounded and would help in accommodating a slightly more amount of yarn while building the base. So with this, we have seen all the mechanisms that are required to build the particular cop, or rather the complicated cop construction, the way it is being built. We have seen the mechanism that is actually there on the ring frame to build that particular cop. So with this, we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you.